Kuzu Zangpo, welcome to Bhutan e-learning project. I'm Doji Dolma from Jimina Primary School, and today we are going to learn mathematics lesson on the stage 2, that is from classes 4 to 6. Today we'll go through the concept of probabilities, some life related examples of probabilities. Now, first of all, you have learned about probabilities in stage 1. Can you tell me what the probabilities means? Okay, the probabilities means it is about describing or predicting an event that is likely or unlikely to occur. So whenever you think of probability, you all the time think it as event which is all the time likely to happen. So it's not like that. It's sometimes unlikely to happen. Well, can you all look here? What is this? Have you seen it before? Okay, this is called as probability line or probability scale. We use this scale to place an event on a correct place and to use the correct probability names or terms. So can you look here? Okay, can you look at A? So it is written as 1% or 100%, and it is written as certain. Why it is written as certain? Because here we put an event which will happen for certain. And can you look at B now? In B, you can see there it is written as 0%. Why 0%? On the top, you can see it is written as impossible. That means never happens. So if an event, you are sure that it will never happen, then you place that event in this 0%. Then you can see C. There you will see half or 50%. Why we put here 50% is here we put an event which are as likely to happen as not likely to happen. So that means it is 50-50%. It can either happen or either not happen. Then you can see E. So there you will see it is unlikely. So here we put an event which you feel is unlikely to happen. Then in D you will see it is written likely. So if you think an event is likely to happen, then you put those events in this D, that is between C and A. Well, children, let's look at some of the examples of probability. Now, first sentence, I will have fruits for breakfast. What do you think? Okay, if I give example of myself, I'll put here very unlikely. Why? Because I never take fruits as breakfast. So because of that one, for me it's very unlikely. But for a person who takes fruits as a breakfast, for that person it will be very likely. So that's how the probability differs from person to person. Now let's look at the second example. A dog will talk to me tomorrow. What do you think? It is impossible. So here it will be impossible for all the person because we never see a dog talking. A dog only barks. Okay, let's discuss once more about the probability scale. The greatest possible probability is 1 because it is certain. So it is 1. And the least possible probability is 0 because it is impossible. Here the incidence never occurs. Now, for example, if you did an experiment 10 times, the most an event could happen is 10 times out of 10, that is 10 over 10. In the scale we put it as 1, and the least it could happen is 0, so it is 0 over 10, which is impossible. For example, if you get 4 times out of 10, you write it as 4 over 10. That means 4 over 10, if you put it on a scale, probability scale, it is closer to where? Half, that is 1 over 2. So you will write there, 4 over 10 is closer to half. Now, if we look at some more examples, what is the probability of a pig flying? Have you ever seen a pig flying? No, we never see a pig flying, only birds fly, yes? So there, the probability on a scale, if you put it on a probability scale, it will be in a zero because it is impossible because we never see a pig flying. Okay, can we look at the second example? What is the probability of getting a natural number on a dice? So here, no matter however we roll a die, we will all the time get natural numbers because on a die there is a numbers from 1 to 6, from numbers 1 to 6, and 1 to 6 they are all natural numbers. So that's why if we place it on a number scale, we will place it in 1. So that means it is certain. Well, children, there are two types of probabilities. First one, let's go through the experimental probabilities. Now, experimental probability, it is based on the result of repeating an experiment many times. Each time is called a trial. A fraction from 0 to 1 can describe an experimental probability. The numerator tells the number of times a particular event occurred. Once more, the numerator tells the number of times a particular event occurred, and the denominator tells the number of events in a sample. Let's look at the formula of finding the experimental probability. Okay, can you all look here? What is this? Okay, it is a coin. Now, how many sides does a coin have? Yes, it has two sides. Now, can we look at one side of the coin? What do we call this? Yes, korlo. We call it as a korlo. Now, another side, what do we call it? It is a trashi dage. Now we are going to do an experiment on experimental probability. We are going to throw it 40 times and record it. While recording, before recording, you need to make sure you have the tables ready for recording. This is the way you draw the table. First one, can you look here? Okay, it is coin side. So below you will write tashidage and korlo. Now, second column, can you look here? Okay, it is the tally mark. If you get, for example, if you get a korlo, you'll put a mark on the korlo, and if you get a tashidage, you'll put a mark in tashidage. So, last column, you'll see number of favorable results. So, there, you'll count the tally marks and then write in numerals. Okay, are you ready? Should we go with the experiment? Okay, ready. Now I'm going to do the trials or throw the coins. Okay, can you see here? It is korlo. So I'll mark in korlo here. One. Okay, look here. It is tashidage. So I'll mark in tashidage. Here, korlo. Okay, now we have finished the trials. Now, should we count the events that you have got? Okay, first, korlo. Count 5, 10, 15, 20, 21, 22. So, in the favorable results, right there, 22. Now, let's count tashidage. 5, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18. Now here, 18. Now, what is the favorable outcome of Khorlo? So, the favorable outcome of Khorlo is 22 over 40. 22 over 40. Now, here you might be thinking, why we are writing about Khorlo only? Because it is the outcome or the event that you wanted to find out is about Khorlo. So, that's why you write for Khorlo only. That is 22 over 40. Now, if you compare experimental probability and the theoretical probability, you will always find them closer to each other. But the thing here that you need to remember is you need to do the experiment many times, then your answer will come closer to theoretical probability. Okay, the theoretical probability is the probability you expect if you think all about the possible outcomes. Now we look at the possible outcomes in theoretical, whereas in experimental, it is the number of trials, okay, and the experimental results. Now theoretical probability, if you find out, here you write numerator, you write it as a number of favorable outcomes. Number of favorable outcomes over number of possible outcomes. Number of possible outcomes, that means that many times you are doing. What is this? This is a die. Now here in die, how many sides are there? There are 6 sides, and there's a number from 1 to 6. From 1 to 6. Now if you want to find out the possible outcomes of number 1, then your theoretical probability would be 1 over 6. Theoretical probability would be 1 over 6. Why? Because there is only one number 1 on this die out of 6. So you write it as 1 over 6. Now let's say you want to find out the probability of getting a number 5. How many 5s would be here? Only 1. So the theoretical probability would be 1 over 6. Now let's find out the probability of not getting number 4. Remember, not getting number 4. So there are 6 numbers. Yes? How many numbers? 6 numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you cut out 4, how many are left? So 5 are left. So that means your theoretical probability would be 5 over 6. 5 over 6. Now let's find out the probability of getting a number 7. Which number? 7. Is there a number 7 here? No, there is no number 7. So the theoretical probability of getting a number 7 is 0. It is 0. Well, children, can you all look here? What are these? They are stars. They are stars. When do we see the stars? Yes, at night we see the stars. Bright and beautiful stars. Yes? And you can see here these stars are of different colors. So we'll find the theoretical probabilities of each colors one by one. Now, before finding out the theoretical probabilities, what you need to find out is you need to look at the number of possible outcomes. You need to look at the number of possible outcomes. That is the total number of stars. Should we count the stars? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many stars are there? Yes, there are 9 stars. Now, to find the theoretical probability of blue star, you need to count the blue stars. Should we count? Okay, 1, 2, 3. How many blue stars are there? 3, yes? So there are 3 blue stars. That means the number of favorable outcomes is 3. That is blue star. So, and the number of possible outcomes was 9. That's the total number of stars. So, theoretical probability, we write it as 3 over 9. 3 over 9. Now, let's try to look at not getting star, that is red in color. Here you can see it is written as P. Yes, P means probability, and in the bracket you can see not red. That means you have to count all the other colors except red. So how many are there? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So other colors are 5. How many are there? 5. So the theoretical probability for not red is 5 over 9. 5 over 9. Now the next question is, you have to look at all the colors except blue and black. Except blue and black. So let's count the other colors, but you should not be counting blue and black. So how many are there? Count 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many are there? 4. So the theoretical probabilities for this one is 4 over 9. 4 over 9. Now children, you have the activity to do. So here is the question. Can you try it yourself? A class has 11 girls and 14 boys. One of them is randomly selected for a committee. Calculate. Well, children, were you able to solve the questions? Hope you have done it. Okay, now, till now you have learned how to find out the theoretical probabilities and the experimental probabilities. And in the experimental probabilities, you learned by doing the experiment. Now, we will learn about the similarities between theoretical probabilities and experimental probabilities. Both are used all around the world by many people. Both are two big parts of probabilities. Both of them helps us to find out the chances of the things happening as well as the chances of things not happening. So in this way, it helps you to make a decisions in your life. Every day in our life, we make a decision. So it's very important to make decisions. And while making decisions, it's very important to look at the advantages and the disadvantages of both the sides so that you'll make an effective decisions which will be helpful to you. Okay, now let's recapitulate what you have learned today. In the first one, you learned the concept of probabilities, the probabilities about describing or explaining about an event that you think are likely or unlikely to occur. Then you learned about how to use the probability line or a probability scale by using the probability terms. Then you learned concept of theoretical probabilities and experimental probabilities, and you also did a experiment. So children, take care, eat healthy foods, wash your hands frequently, stay safe. Bye bye and tashidele.